Yeah. Well, not toy chest, but chest. Yeah.
Thank you. this room, where shadows live and ghosts that failed learn time forgives. Welcome, friends. Please stay a while. Our story starts with one small child who spends this night in an attic dark where dreams are stored like sleeping hearts. Now, if you wonder why this child is here with all the sleep and Christmas near, she had heard from friends who feel that nothing on this night is real. That this night that seems to cast a spell is the same old world, just tinseled well. And as she lay in bed that night, she wondered if they might be right. That no adult truly believes in all these things of Christmas Eve. And that these gifts that we all wait for are all hidden behind attic doors. So she's come up here looking for truth in this place closest to the roof. And among these memories, disguised as junk, she noticed there a well-worn trunk. It was filled with toys and one old wreath and several letters underneath. All threads of long-forgotten lives. But here, somehow, they had survived. And these letters that had caught her eye, now in her hands, they seemed alive. And with each letter that she unsealed, a small piece of the past was revealed. For Christmas weaves a lifelong spell, and most of all, remembers well. And as that child explored the past, once again, that spell was cast. And so, the child begins to read, upon this night of Christmas Eve.
It's dark, where dreams are stored like sleeping hearts. And so it's here that they must wait till someone wishes them away. For somewhere on this night of nights, she's looking to believe. Here among the ghosts on Christmas Eve. There, near an old looking glass, there was a trunk from Christmas past that she had somehow missed before, but now decides she will explore. 'Twas filled with toys and one old wreath and several letters underneath. So as the evening hours leave, the child sits down and starts to read. For somewhere on this night of nights, she's looking to believe. Here among the ghosts on Christmas Eve.
that first letter that she had read in that attic, far from bed, was from a father trying to say how his first child saw Christmas Day. And after he had thought a while, the father recalled another child, born in a time now far away, and how that child's dreams had reached this day.
There was a cold winter night when the dark went on forever and the world seemed like a dream gone astray. But somehow there on this night, as the world at the end of the day, when he dreamed of another world in another time and another place, where no man has to wear a sign saying where he's from, saying what's his race, and he wants us to be. This world that he sees, we
Then she saw a gramophone from a time gone long before any in this room were born. But tonight, it would be heard once more. For she had found a small handle there upon one end. And when she turned it twice around, it began to play again. Was a young boy's school report about the three wise men and how they nearly had been caught. Now, Now, many books have been written about what happened on that night. But this report was based on some additional insight. It seems his uncle had come by each Christmas without fail and claimed to know what really happened in that classic Christmas tale.
Curiosity! reach the end of our story. Where Granite and the Kings reach that stable on the hill. And while I said that three kings in the desert's a rare sight, angels singing in the desert, that's far rarer still.
Would not be left behind. child still knows this night we pray our lives will show this dream he had. Each child
she found was by a ribbon gently bound to the key for a small music box. And she placed that key into its lock, and the melody that it had learned, it once more began to turn.
Thank you.
letter that was there. That letter contained the news clipping about a man with many things. In his world, a big success. Where he lived, the best address. His happy life, the world didn't know. Because the papers told us so. And then this night, whispered in his ear. And in his mind, the man heard clear. Tell me one wish that you have granted. Tell me one life that you've enchanted. Tell me one of these things that you have done. But the man could not recall a single one. He was close to no one. This thing he did know. Well, there was one person from his school days. But he had let her go. And though this person was far more than a friend, it was far too late to ever go back to her again.
Until all the sea.
There's something about this night that the Lord hath arranged that reaches deep into our souls and causes us to want to change. This night knows something about us that no one else can know. This night, it formed a plan, then caused the skies to start to snow. She had carefully read that article. And when she was all done, she started on the next letter. And it was the saddest one.
Remember. wished upon again. But the music box continues to turn.
Thank you.
behind that single letter was a weathered photograph of that man in the article. But from somewhere in his past, and on the shelf, there beside him, in a setting summer sun, was the lady who used to own this house. But here, she was quite young. She had moved to a smaller place, only right next door. And then the child, she noticed something else that she had missed before. This letter, it had no stamp, it seemed, and was surely never sent. And as she sat upon that floor, the child, she wondered what it meant. And then this night, whispered to her a most important fact, that for compassion to be real, it requires one to act. So she took the article back downstairs, and she found the kitchen phone. Then she called up information for the number of his home. When he picked up the receiver, she quickly told him quite enough to know who, on this night, was waiting for him. And then the child, she just hung up. Then, to make sure that no one was awake, she took a quick look down the hall. Then she found her neighbor's number and repeated that same call.
A railway station on a long forgotten line. No destination, but it always leaves on time. He buys his ticket as the train prepares to leave. Don't want to miss it on this evening Christmas Eve. As the snow fell from the sky, his consolation
Understand.
So he took the message from this night and became a different man.
Myself there unseen. The book was the word, and the word there was truth, and the truth there was age, and the age there was you. And I said to the child, do your hands they still bleed? After all of this time, do you think there's still me? The child only smiled and said not a word, and the snow it came down as if it hadn't heard.
Take care.
Every time to life, such a thing must be, but such a thing must not be known this night.
When she had finished that last letter from that little stack, she put each one in its envelope and she carefully
in this city and one other one, and I always experiment with it when I get here. It's strange, it's this weird reaction. I say one word and it happens. I go, Cleveland. It's so weird that that happens. We've been on the road for 16 years. We would not have made it past 16 days without the greatest fans on the planet, you guys. Give yourselves a round of applause. We thank you. Shows yesterday, two today, two tomorrow. We cannot do that schedule without the greatest crew on the planet. So please give every member of our road crew a huge round of applause. And that includes Mr. Brian Hartley. He designs our lights. He's back there. This light show for you every year. And our sound engineer, he not only does the live sound, he's recorded every single note we've ever done in the studio. And he was born and raised in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Coming all the way from London, England, Georgia Napolitano.
From Montreal, Canada, Lisa Levee. From Dallas, Texas, Kayla Reed. Dustin Braley. From the Netherlands, Robin Bordeman. Sir Russell Allen. And the one and only Mr. Rob Evan. Once again, the TSO vocalist and Mr. Brian Hicks. Give it up extremely loud in Pittsburgh. I need Mr. Joel Hoekstra, the birthday boy, am I right? Caroline's on the stand, turn it up, it's time to jail!
Thank you.
there was no hero. That was my old man, and he came back home where he met his wife, and he raised his kids while he made a life. Now he never preached, though we always knew, and we watched him close just to pick up clues. But sometimes late in the dead of night, I can see him there in the pale moonlight. I am trying, and I don't know how, and I don't know.
Thank you.
tell me, Christmas, are we wise to believe in things we never see? Our prayers just wishes in disguise, and all those wishes being granted me. Christmas Day. So tell me, Pittsburgh, are we kind? More this day than any Christmas Day. Always took the scene, no matter who. Now she's coming home this
take this time now to thank who we feel is the most important group of people by far, and that is each and every member, past, present, and future of our United States military. They protect our lives and our freedom, and we acknowledge that every show gives you it. So, all right, you guys ready to meet the band? Awesome. We're going to start with our string section. Our strings today, these are members of local Pennsylvania Symphony Orchestra, so please give your own strings a huge round of applause. Conducting our strings today, tonight, every show on this tour, it's Rowdy Ronnie Chubb! On the bicep, I mean bass guitar, David Z! My partner in crime on the electric guitar, and it happens to be his birthday today, so everybody say, happy birthday, Joel! Mr. Joel Hoekstra! On keyboards, born in Korea, and I believe the first time we came through Pittsburgh was 15 years ago. She was playing keyboards back then. Please welcome back Miss Mia Kim! The man on the drums! 16 years ago, we played the very first show, actually, in Pennsylvania, but it was Philadelphia. He's on the drums then every tour since. Mr. Jeff Plate! And last, but certainly not least, this gentleman to my left, he is our musical director, also on keyboards. Please give a warm welcome for Mr. Derek Whelan. My name is Chris Caffrey, and we are the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. Two of our favorite keyboard players ever. Right now, they're going to pay a little tribute to a few of theirs, so check this out. Thank you. Christmas, an extremely happy New Year. We'll see you next time on the Trans-Siberian Orchestra.